Hey, what's up everybody, my name is Trophynet and welcome back to Bioshock 2 in our Let's Replay series, where we try to delve a bit deeper into the story every time we, especially every time we find an audio diary. And I tell you a bit about the game and how it came to be. Especially this level, because it's very interesting since it started out as a pretty pristine level, but turned out the complete opposite. But, as you can see, I fortified the defenses a bit. I think if anybody gets through here alive, I'm gonna clap slowly so they appreciate what they've done. But let's gather at them. Yes, I can see it glow. So I'm gonna try and stay over here.
You're coming home with me.
Okay, she's coming home with you, apparently. Ooh, they're coming in. That's... yep. There we go. Yep, they're abort. Oh, how? You're dead.
It's me. Thank God that's over. I'm gonna be gone.
There we go.
Come on, Daddy.
And that's pretty much everybody. I must say they pretty much triggered every single trap there was. I think there's 4 cyclone traps left just because they didn't take the wider route as I expected. But let's pick her up. Yes, and I'm very nice. I'm always very nice, especially to you, girl. Especially to you. I did kind of spend a lot of EVE on that, but that's not bad, because of course, kind of got me out of a tough spot. Didn't really have any problems in this attack. But, let's go with the drill. No, wait. Shotgun! Good old shotty! Let's take the good old shotty and take a look around with what everybody dropped here. There were a few dead spider spices in between as well. They usually have a bit more loot, but cannot carry any more drill fuel. Oh, apparently I can't. That was very nice of the game. So that was one gather, and now that we're here, might as well check if the corpse at the end of this place actually has... can I repair you? No, I can't. Yeah, there's one as well. So let's just add a few more cyclone traps. The turrets are active, kinda. But there's a lot of cameras anyway. So this turret's kinda got blown to shit because of me. But let's set up a few cyclone traps. Give me a second. And while we're here, there's an audio diary hidden in the ice pile, by the way, that I missed. Falling into place.
New face. I have a new goddamn face. Who'd have thought? Rapture. Paradise of the confidence man. I gotta keep revising the Atlas voice. I figure the accent gives me an excuse to lock myself in a room with a bottle and count the cash. War's on in full now, boy. And I've got a hell of a surprise for Andrew Ryan. Long time coming. And right about now, I expect the prodigal son is booking his flight.
So there we go, Frank Fontaine talking about how he became Atlas. And of course, the prodigal son is Jack Ryan, the protagonist of the previous game that booked the flight and then crashed the airplane right above Rapture, staging it as an accident. But let's gather this corpse. Again, doesn't look really, really safe, but never mind. Hello? I hear splicers, but... how the hell... where did you even come from?
This angel's
glowing. There we go, that was a hit. And that one... that one flew all over the place. Let's just keep an eye on this with... there we go, send them out.
You're a worm.
And that one hit the ceiling. And she is. Nope, he's dead. Never mind. He that was pretty brutal. What is she doing? Is she a Houdini splice? It seems she is. Ow, stop firing at me. Okay, so now they're firing at the turret for some reason. Hello, are you still saving this blazing inferno? Thank you very much. There we go, another 60 atom, and conveniently we're right next to a little sister vent. Still don't know where that splicer came from, but let's rescue her, of course, as we always do. So put my hand on her head, and I don't know, chase the demon away, chase the devil away. Goodbye! And here we go.
Father, this atom you found contains memories from all the bodies here. Normally, only a little sister can see them, but I can show you what Stanley's trying to hide. When Mother was taken away, Stanley was left in charge of Dionysus Park. He spent all her money through these mad parties. It was like he was trying to ruin her.
Which makes sense, because if she would come back...
You okay there? Keep your eye on the brass ring, brother. Find the rest of the sisters.
So Stanley doesn't realize that we actually got the memories from the Adam. But actually kind of makes sense that he was trying to, spend all the money that Lam has. Because, if she ever got back... He would want to make sure that she didn't have much assets to, do anything with that.
Subject Delta's just a serial number, amigo. I did a lot of digging on you for a feature once. They used to call you Johnny Topside. Found the city all on your own in a diving bell. Real shame what they did to you.
So there we go. The Johnny Topside we've been hearing a bit about. Is actually us. We were turned into a big daddy as a test when we found Rapture by accident. So that's not really friendly of these guys, right? We still don't know who exactly turned us into a big daddy, but that just adds a bit to the lore as well. So let's hack this vending machine quickly. Thank you very much. Sardines! Yeah, I've always wanted sardines. Let's buy a few Eve hypos and fill up on the anti-personnel rounds. We're actually out of rivets a bit, so let's use the machine gun for a bit and drink some fresh water. We've been over there in the gallery, so that thing is done. We've been in the frozen hellhole, and now we need to go look for more little sisters.
You mistake my nature, Delta. I wish no Adam... for myself. Eleanor is the dream, and she needs neither weapons nor parlor tricks.
So Eleanor is the dream. She just claims that she doesn't want the Adam for her, but for Eleanor, so for the great plan to put all the Adam in the world into Eleanor's body. Which I can only assume is not good for her, probably. We never actually checked out this room. Hello? Eve Hypos, remote hack guard, lots of loot apparently. Seems like a room where there should be an audio diary around here as well. But I might be mistaken as well, of course, as usual. Yeah, nothing here. What was that? Kate Merlot, I'm not gonna drink some wine, thank you very much. So that's the piano bar, I think. Yeah, there's nothing else here. Although I think I can actually play the piano if I want to. We haven't done that yet. Let's do that. Sounds a bit bad. Although it was playing on its own a while ago. That door just leads back to the merry-go-round. So let's go back the other way. Through this area. Because it's kind of a maze. It's kind of a big area, Dionysus Park. With a lot of levels as well. So if you lose your way, you might be in for quite a trip. Anything around here? I know there can be a lot of splicers in this area as well, but apparently Not right now, so it kinda sounds like I'm making all of this up again. It's okay. That was not very smart of you, I think. Oh god. Okay, that was weird, kind of. What is going on? That actually did more damage than... Oh, for fuck's sake, never mind. The first two rockets just went straight through my body for some reason. I don't know why, but hey. A rocket turret is always handy, and I actually missed the effect of the research there. We leveled that up, but I don't know what happened with it. Spider Splicer, thank you very much. Don't really need to check this, I think. Yeah, never mind. Spears, let's start using a bit of spears. Always, always very, very much fun, very much fun. Shocking. Yeah, why not? Yeah, that hasn't been open for quite a while, so let's pick up the proximity mines. Yeah, I'm all out of space, of course. So let's get that first aid kit at least. And let's see. Because this kind of looks familiar, doesn't it? The outside maybe less. But yeah, the Triton. So that's also another name for Poseidon. But this is a theater.
Adam is Rapture Delta. The finest minds of paradise in a single sublime mosaic. Elena. Consider the genius you deny her with every stolen drop.
Take it easy, Sophia Lam. Do you really think it's such a good idea to put every guy's mind, well, every dude of Rapture, every genius in Rapture, his intellect into one single person? Especially since you were talking about how bad the egos of all of these guys were. Sorry if I'm nonchalantly shooting women in the face, but sorry for that. Can I have that? Ooh. Ooh. She's gonna have a tough time swallowing something anytime soon. She's kind of deep-throating that spear. Sorry for that. Let's not do that again. Well, I do like headshots, but not mouth shots. That's just bad. Let's see, so that's... We're in bathrooms again. We're constant... Bioshock is 50% bathrooms, I kind of feel. No, it adds to the water mystique, but what's this? Electrical Storm. Ryan Industries introduces the latest in wartime deterrent genetics. Electrical Storm makes you a walking Tesla coil, zapping anything and everything foolish enough to strike you. So yeah, the fancier term for static discharge from the previous game. Not gonna use that just yet. I don't think we're gonna enter this bathroom again, so let's just... Oh, hi, holy shit, okay, that was terrifying. Fuck you, seriously. Oh shit. Seriously? Fuck off. That just... Wow, that gave me goosebumps. I didn't even hear that guy. Whew, okay, but I do kind of love the level design in this place. Now that it has the chance, it had the chance to get overgrown with everything from the sea, I do love what they did with this level. But we are still looking for the next big daddy. And for some reason, he's not here yet. So yeah, this theater looks a lot like the Fleet Hall from Bioshock 1 and, yeah, again, from Fort Frolic, the Sander Cohen area. Let's take all the potato chips, stuff that in my mouth. Canned fruit, all that, yes. Ooh, remote hacktard, always handy. And then all the cola to get my Eve back. And I do hear a big daddy.
There she is. Little Tyke wants to be in pictures. Real cute. Now get rid of the muscle and deal with her.
Yeah, get rid of the muscle and deal with her. Take it easy, Stanley, take it easy. So there's a spider spicer, don't know what he's doing. Hello? Are you going to attack him or... Are you... What are you... Oh, hi. I do need to research you, so... Seriously? Jesus. Hello there. These guys are fighting. And after that drill, this guide to death increased damage against Houdini splicers, always handy. And now, we do need to research this guy, don't we? Let's see. Rocket spears, of course. I might pop two in his ass while we're starting. Putting down... What? What have I done to you now? God damn it, just coming into the theater, firing your machine gun. Or shotgun. Jesus Christ, it's incredible what people do these days. Hello, Big Daddy. Let's fire away the irony. There we go. Increased damage. So is that just gonna stop the... Yeah, okay, never mind. Let's put two rocket spears in his ass. Let's swap out to the mini turret. Set that down high. Are you not interested in the thing that's firing up your ass? Ooh, this is not working. This is, though. Let's take all of that. Let's zap him a bit. Grenades. And that took him out. Okay. Thank you very much. Let's search. 70 drill fuel, $50 and 2 proximity mines. Haven't used those yet. I really should, but taking
Daddy,
out...
You always save me.
It gets me every time. They're crying in the moment you step closer there. Hi, Daddy. Can I come on top of your shoulder? I'm gonna be really, really nice today. Okay, let's just get you up there. So yeah, I really like, because this is almost an exact replica of the previous theater. Aside from the fact that it doesn't have the side areas, but does have an upper balcony up there. But hey, let's take a look around, because I think I know there's another corpse we can harvest up there. With a lot of spider splices getting up our ass. Hello? And then the Houdini splicer over here underneath the curtain. Let's take the aspirin for some reason. Can't take anything out of the pneumo, but I do want some first aid kits. So if I can find those, that would be really handy.
My own clothes. Who'd have thought?
Okay.
Me of all people.
Me of all people. I have 50 caliber rounds for you. If you...
Oh, darling, 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 you shouldn't have. Where are... I dropped that poor little girl.
Nope. No, I'm not gonna drop her. Sorry. Sorry, I'm not gonna drop my poor little girl. Because, well, she's probably safer with me than with you. Because how are you gonna defend her from everything in this horrible place? But, a secular saint.
The genius of Sophia Lamb is a thing of empathy. A profound moral sense. I can only describe her as a kind of secular saint. But dividing her loyalty evenly across the world at large spreads it so thin as to be invisible to some. Love, I have found, is beneath her. Naturally, Ryan arrested her, gave her to Sinclair to incarcerate somewhere. But upon her escape, she took the city and changed my life forever.
So there we go, Jill Alexander confirming her love, his love for Sophia Lamb, which is, well, kind of creepy. Yeah, we have another gather. I'm gonna end it with that.
Wrong.
Hi. That's, you're supposed to be dropping if you're short. Seriously? I just whacked him with a machine gun. We can do that. I never actually used that, but we can whack splices with a machine gun. Let's reload that again, and let's take a look around. Ooh, a gas bottle. I know what I'm gonna do with that. I'm gonna put that right over here in the middle of the staircase. Put that down and then pop a nice proximity mine right next to that. There we go. Look at that. That's gonna explode the moment somebody crosses that. And then, of course, a lot of cyclone traps. In the meantime, you can listen to this audio diary, A Spy.
At last, we have our Judas. One of my own people has been feeding Ryan evidence of my activities. And now, I am to be detained. As a religion, they merely monitored us. But as a commune, they would see us crucified. And yet, though he will be the last to see it. Andrew Ryan has already lost the people. Wherever I am sent, rapture will follow.
There we go. So somebody in her inner circle betrayed her, probably Stanley Poole, as the things are standing right now. Let's change these to electrobolt traps since they're in the water. I don't think, are there any else? No. Oh. Is that limited? I never actually realized that. That apparently is limited. But never mind. They're close to everything over here. So let's gather at them. There we go. I heard a brute splice already. Hello? God damn it. Where's the other one? Okay, that was pretty heavy. Let's pick her up. I don't know what's happening, but the music is going haywire. What is going on? Oh. God damn it. Okay, this is bad. As you can see, the game crashed on me, and Bioshock is really, really bad on auto-saving. So Bioshock only auto-saves when you move from one area to the next. And since we haven't done that in two episodes, I'm back at the start of the previous episode. Don't worry, that won't have any effect on you. But I'm gonna have to replay the last two episodes. But with that, I'm gonna take a little break. Because, yeah, I can't really continue right now. So thank you guys enormously for watching. If you enjoyed the episode, don't forget to like it right here on YouTube. And if you haven't already, don't forget to give it a thought to subscribe to my channel. Because I'd really appreciate any support you guys can give me. So thanks again enormously for watching, and I hope to see you in the next video or series where I will have replayed this again. So, goodbye.